I can't do this anymore. There is so much to learn about AI. I don't even know where to start. Like, what is the point? It's just consuming me. It's too much. I give up. Don't give up, second Tiff. I got you covered, and I got all of you covered. In this video, we are going to go through some of the easiest ways. I'm going to break down for you how you can simply learn AI. There's some tricks here I got covered for you. All right, let's get into it. To start with, there are many different areas within AI that you can focus on, depending on what your end goal is and interests. For example, there is the technical understanding, so things such as really understanding the fundamental concepts, programming concepts, and then also too, really using AI for a problem-solving tool. Now, this doesn't always need to be falling under technical, but just to keep it simple. Then we have the societal impact. So this is things covering such as ethics and bias, jobs and the future of work, privacy and security. This is, I know, of interest to a lot of you, especially around the ethics with AI and the bias that it can create. This is a whole other area within artificial intelligence that you can spend time focusing on. And then there's this third category, which is really more generic, depending on more specialties, where it be really having a strong understanding as to using different AI tools, or maybe you are more so understanding AI's current limitations, different things like that. All right, we just went through three big buckets at a high level as to where you can put your focus when you are learning about AI. And already, it seems kind of like a lot. So let's break down what each bucket really entails, because that will give you a good sense as to where you are most interested and should put your focus to learning with artificial intelligence, what relates most to you, and kind of the next steps into how to really learn and understand AI that best relates to what you are working on, your job, and the future. All right, let's start by going back to bucket number one, more of the technical concepts. And just hold on a sec, even if you are a non-technical person, you're gonna wanna hear this. Let's cover some of the basics within artificial intelligence, different terms that you should be aware of and know what they mean. They oftentimes get thrown around interchangeably when in reality, they are pretty different. Artificial intelligence, we really use a lot of times incorrectly. We just kind of use it as this term to cover anything and everything with, you know, under AI's kind of umbrella, when in reality, there is so much more to it. Let's start out actually with a few of the basics. All right, let's get into machine learning. What exactly is machine learning? Think of it as training algorithms to learn patterns from data and make predictions or decisions. So you are feeding this algorithm some data, and based on that, it is learning and getting trained to make better decisions and predictions. And this learning can happen through various methods, through supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. Now, we're not gonna dive into those three today, but just save this video if you are interested in it, or write these down, and you can, I mean, machine learning we could make for a whole series of videos, essentially. Next up, let's cover deep learning. So deep learning you can think of as an advanced subset of machine learning. So deep learning uses multi-layered neural networks to analyze various factors of data. So you can think of it, deep learning, as a really good task or tool for things such as image and speech recognition, really complex tasks. Then we have a subset within deep learning, which is neural networks. Stay with me here. I know it can get complex fast, but this is just very high level to at least give you an understanding as to what these different terms that people throw around actually mean. Neural networks are inspired by the human brain. I mean, when you think neural, obviously the brain, so just kind of to keep that in your back pocket. Neural networks, though, are a series of algorithms that mimic the operations of the human brain to recognize relationships within a set of data. And they are key, a foundational part to deep learning, which we just went through. All right, the last one I want to cover is something that we often hear get thrown around, especially in the news or especially on social media, which is AGI, or artificial general intelligence. And I think this gets thrown around because of the what ifs around it. Like, what if this actually happened with AI, and kind of gives this very futuristic, kind of fear-mongering social post it can oftentimes. So this is a concept where AGI has the ability to understand, learn, and apply new concepts to solve different problems on its own. And it's really similar to how a human brain works. Okay, so still under topic number one, technical concepts, or technical as a whole. Obviously, there's the entire programming section of this too, where there are so many different courses you can take. Gone are the days where you would have to go to school for computer science and learn everything the traditional way in order to become a machine learning engineer. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not discrediting that form of education. It is key, and especially for very specific roles. But I don't want you to get discouraged that if you didn't go to school for computer science, you can't explore these options. The good thing is there are so many courses online. Here are some courses though that really start with the basics, the foundation that I just covered, and work their way up. The first one I want to cover is a Stanford course that is on machine learning covered by or hosted by Coursera. It really starts as to what is machine learning and then breaks or works its way down to the nitty gritty. So this is a course, whether you are technical or not, you can learn a lot from it. Okay, another course that is offered by Coursera, they offer some amazing courses. This isn't even sponsored by them, but I love them. So deep learning specialization. And so this is actually a series of 5 courses to help you understand deep learning. And it will help you also not only understand deep learning, and you'll get more into the specifics around building, training, and deploying neural networks. So it really starts getting into the details, especially around deep learning. All right, let's jump into the second column, which is societal impact. So this is if you are more interested, maybe in this side of things. When we start learning about AI and really getting into that world, one thing you will quickly come to realize is there is so much to learn. And oftentimes that can make you feel so intimidated, you just back away from it and be like, ah, this isn't for me. That's why I really wanted to break it down to these 3 columns. And then within them, there is still so much to learn. So really focus or hone in on one thing. And then from there, you'll just over time continually gain information and educate yourself on others. Don't try and learn everything at once. All right, so under societal impact, we have ethics and bias in AI algorithms. And it's no secret, there's been tons of conversations around this that there are some issues or challenges when it comes to bias within AI. And you know, AI generated images, such as the ones that DALL-E creates, can raise ethical concerns about bias, discrimination, privacy, and even job displacement. I mean, when we look at when AI was first starting to be able to generate art, I think that was a huge concern and still is. And there's this really fine line or friction we are facing right now as to who sets the regulations, where does the line stop? And also too, when the regulations are set, the line keeps on changing as technology is literally changing, it seems like on a day-to-day basis. And I think this is really interesting, AI ethics, for anyone who is really passionate about legal, psychology, anything around the more the human brain, anything like that, I think you will really find AI ethics really interesting and something to start looking into as a place to start learning about AI. And there is such a need for AI ethicists, people who study this really carefully, because AI is the worst it will ever be, meaning it's continuing to grow and get better and better. And we need to start putting regulations and really thoughtful considerations into place as to what this will look like moving forward. Then we have jobs or the future of work. And you know, this is an area that I love to explore, mainly because it's so interesting to me how AI will impact jobs not only today, but in the future, as well as how we learn different skills. Our learning will change, and even our skills will change too, because of AI. Now, what can you learn under here? For me, one thing that I really focus on is understanding as to how AI impacts us currently, and then what it can looking ahead. So this kind of, you had to put your futurist cap on or futurist hat on, where you're making assumptions based on the data that is available today as to what it could look like moving forward. And then taking that and educating others as to where to put their time and skills when learning about AI, as to how it will help them grow in their career. All right, the third pillar we have is what I called kind of the generic or beyond the basics, where it's more specialized areas. This could be things such as maybe you're passionate about AI, but you really want to focus in on some AI tools. This could literally be you becoming an expert and learning more so about what AI tools are offered, what are the best AI tools for specific things. All right, and on that note, you want to know something really cool? Is you can now use the GPT store, which just released, to actually educate yourself on all of these topics as well. I recently was on the GPT store and I found Consensus, and I was going through their GPT, custom GPT, and it is really impressive actually. It goes through, it says your AI research assistant, so you can search 200 million academic papers from Consensus. So you'll get science-based answers and it will help you draft content with accurate citations. So I thought this was really cool. I just stumbled across it and I've been using it recently to understand different concepts within artificial intelligence, and it's worked really well for me because you know it's coming from actual scientists. There's over 200 million data that's, 200 million academic papers, that's located in there. So it's it's a great way as well to start your learning. All right, at the end of the day, if you are interested in learning AI, don't let or consume you just how much information is out there and become so overwhelming you learn nothing. Take it step by step. We went through some key concepts today. Also too, I shared with you some key courses to really lay that foundation. And then from there, you can kind of branch off into different areas that we went through. Thank you all for watching. I hope you found this video educational, inspirational as to where to put your focus based on your interests. Hit that subscribe button and I'll see you all soon. Thanks everyone. I always end the same way. I gotta get more creative. What's like a creative ending I should do? Leave in the comments, help me out.